How's it been so far with this weight to come back in the cage?
I'm actually not worried about my weight. I've been walking around at like 120-ish, you know. So I used to walk around way higher than that and made 105, so I'm not worried about that, you know. I have a nutritionist, so they'll help me make weight. But I really, really want to get back in there, you know. I have new coaches. Dave Heath, he's a former UFC fighter. Clay Mars, he's a top-level grappler. I also have some new training partners that weigh like 150.
You know, looking at the division, you know, what do you think about it right now? Obviously, there's a lot of talent that you could be fighting eventually.
I think it's actually thinned out a lot since a lot of the girls moved to 115, but it definitely, there's a lot of up and comers coming up at 105, so I would like to fight, you know, pretty soon, any one of them, Amber Brown, Diana Rael, you know, maybe whoever Invicta wants to see me against, but those are just a couple names.
We're seeing a lot more Americans make their way into that list. It was very heavily Japanese fighters on that list for a while. What does that mean to you to have access to more of these top 10 talents that are actually here in the U.S. that you can face?
It means a lot to me because I'm not in MMA to just fight. I want to be the champion one day. So to fight people in the top 10, that's what I want. So.
Yeah, I think a lot of people want to see you. Obviously, you have a lot of fans that want to see you. You know, at Invicta 9 or at Invicta 10 as well. You know, what's it been like to get all that support from a lot of people saying, yeah, we want to see you back?
It's been amazing because I've never really had that, like, before in my career until I fought for Invicta. So it's really nice to have that support from the fans. I love my fans, so I just want to thank them. Thank you, guys! So it's just really nice to have that, you know.
Yeah, now you're helping out a lot of fighters with a management team. Can you tell us a little bit about that?
I'm just like a partner for Sangre Management, and it's really small. We're trying to really grow it, really know each girl personally and try to personalize it for them, you know, just because I've had a lot of really bad experiences with management before, so.
Yeah, because we're seeing a lot more managers making out there and trying to help out as well. There's some good, some bad, you know, so obviously you know a lot, and your partners know a lot about what's going on, so that does bring a little bit more of a personal aspect to it.
Yeah, it does. He's from New York, so he has a lot of connections there, and I don't know. We'll see what happens with it.
Yeah, so we can hope for maybe 9, maybe 10, and obviously you want Amber Brown, who's signed to the company, so we'll have to put that out there. But you know, obviously being here at Invicta, you know, what does it mean to kind of be back at this event and kind of you know, even if you're not fighting, be in the atmosphere and to be in front of Shannon and let her know, you know, I'm gonna fight.
It means a lot to me because, you know, it's just like old friends, you know, it's like kind of like a reunion, you know. I get to see a lot of people that I've known for a long time, you know, because I've been in this game since about 2005, 2006, so, you know, it's nice. I saw Shayna, Veronica, you know, Julie, you know, Michelle, who I really like. So.
Yeah, I mean, it's been a long road. I mean, you know, when you were fighting, you probably were fighting up at like 125 and all that as well, but now you're down to 105 at your natural weight. What does it mean to you, looking back, that you had the opportunity to fight at 105, the natural fight weight you should be at?
I'm so happy that there's 105 now, because at 125 I felt tiny, and at 115 I felt tiny, so it just feels really good to be able to fight and compete at what I feel is like the highest level I can be at. So I just really came to watch Michelle fight because I like her and I like her style and stuff, and she's exciting, and Tomata, I think she's exciting as well, and I think it'll be like a really exciting fight between the two. I see Michelle winning, but that's just my opinion, and I'm biased because I like her. So.
I mean, yeah, it's absolutely amazing, and like I said, this is the first, you know, time that this on Fight Pass and all that as well, and you know, have you been in contact with Miesha as of late? I know she's up in Seattle. She's not going to be able to make it, I don't think.
I have been. She gets really busy around fight camp time, and me being a fighter, I try to respect that. So, you know, little text messages here and there, you know. So, but, yeah, I've been in contact with her.
Yeah, I was going to say, I mean, you know, maybe with a fight camp, you know, if you do have a fight camp from Invicta, are you thinking about going down to Extreme Couture and doing a little training with Miesha at all?
I'm actually have been thinking about that. Maybe going for like a week or something, you know, to go train with her. Just because I know they have some smaller girls to train with, and I don't really have smaller girls to go with. I do have some girls to go with now, but they're all bigger, like 20 pounds bigger than me, so.
She's doing such a great job at that fight team. I mean, we're seeing a lot of girls come in, and she's really, really kind of taken Extreme Couture by the reins and said, you know, we're going to do a female fight team like the old days. And sure enough, we're seeing a lot of great talent out of there. So, you know, you got to be a little bit proud about that.
I am. I'm really proud of Miesha. I've known her since the Bodog hook and shoot days, which was like 2007. I've really enjoyed seeing her grow as a fighter and as a person, and, you know, she's going to start managing girls, and she's actually helped me a lot in my career, you know, telling me you should market yourself, you should set yourself apart from different girls, you know, talk about what your interests are, you know, she's really helped me a lot, so I think she has a lot to offer as far as, like, where she's been in her fight career to help other girls as well, you know, and she is a tough person, like, sparring her, she is so tough. I've never seen another female like as tough as her. She's got so much heart.
Okay, any sponsors that you have, you know, in the works for this next, hopefully the next Invicta, fingers crossed. Any other shout outs as well?
I do have some sponsors, but I would like to keep them under wraps until hopefully I get all nine. But the one that I always have is Babes of MMA. I'd like to give you guys a shout out, and Sangre Entertainment. Hey guys. And That's about it right now.
At Nicdali on Twitter, of course.
Yes, at Nicdali, N-I-C-D-A-L-I, and on Instagram, same thing. And if you want to find me on Facebook, same thing. So I'm the only one.
Well, I look forward to being able to see you at 9. We're all kind of crossing our fingers that you get to be on 9. So,
Shannon, please 9.